you are working and studying for the bar exam, you do not need me to tell you how busy you are and likely how sleep deprived you feel and how stressed out you are. But the good news is you can do this. We've helped many, many people who have to work and study successfully get past the bar exam. So in this video, I want to give you 12 tips, and these are time-tested tips. These aren't things we just made up. These are tips that our actual students have used to help be successful at the bar exam while balancing a job. So our first tip is that you should try to talk to your boss or your supervisor about the fact that you are preparing to take the bar exam. We think that this is really important because it helps the two of you get on the same page. It might help set up boundaries about what you can or can't do, especially if you used to be super, super flexible. And it might just help them cut you some slack. But nonetheless, it puts everyone on the same page. Now, there are some people that are afraid to tell their boss about the bar exam because they think their boss might retaliate in some way. If this is the case for you, don't tell them then. Or, you know, make your own personal choice about what you do. But we find that most employers are pretty flexible in understanding about the bar exam. And if they don't understand the bar exam, they're willing to listen to why it's challenging and kind of what their employees are going through. So if possible, talk to your boss so that they understand what's going on in your life and the expectations are clear. The second tip is to make a bar exam study schedule. Make sure it's realistic and then stick to it. You're going to be too busy to have to constantly be reassessing what you should be doing and when. So put together a schedule, make it realistic so you can stick to it, and then that's it. Move on from there. Our third tip is start studying early, and this is so important. It probably should have been tip number one. A traditional bar prep course is about 8 weeks, and it's assuming that someone is studying full time. So this means you probably want to double that, which means you want to give yourself at least 3 months, maybe 4 months to be able to study. And this is important too, because it will take a little bit of the pressure off because you're already factoring in the reality that you have to work and share your time and attention. Our fourth tip is you should take some time to figure out where and when you're going to study. If possible, we recommend you study early in the day. So again, I think if you can take some of the legwork and thought process out of the studying because you already have a game plan, you're just going to be more effective and be less exhausted. So if you already know that you need to go to the library or if you're going to go to your favorite coffee shop to study, great. You know, outline that in your study schedule. We find that a lot of people report back to us that they just get up early and they sit down at their kitchen table where there's less distractions than if they tried to study at 5 p.m. with kids running around and emails and the phone ringing. So I get it. Studying in the morning might not sound great to you, and that's okay. Figure out something that works. But we truly find that sometimes starting early in the day before the day happens, make sure it ensures that studying actually occurs and that it's productive. Another tip is that you should take time for breaks. And you're probably rolling your eyes at me because you're thinking, I don't have time to do what I have to do, let alone breaks. But the reality is, if you're following our advice and you're starting to study early on, you will have time for breaks. And that's really important because for you to be effective at studying and job and everything else you have going on in your life, you're going to need some you time and some downtime. Our sixth tip is to study smart. This means you should be using efficient materials. So make sure that before you commit to a bar prep company, you've looked at their outlines and their materials, or you've shopped around to make sure that you're not creating more work for yourself. You do not want to be saddled with three outlines that say the same thing in different ways. You want to know that you have one outline that you can use and focus on and memorize. You want to make sure that you have access to summaries of highly tested areas of law and the like. We have a lot of this stuff, so be sure to check out our website if you're not already familiar with it. Our seventh tip is to tell people that you're studying. We find that if you let the rest of the world know, like not only your boss, but your family and your friends know, that you're going to be pretty short on time in the coming months, it makes everyone else understand. And they're going to put a little bit less pressure on you to hang out or be available. And therefore, you're less frequently put in the position to have to say, no, I have to study. If you put people on notice about what you have going on in your life and this challenge you have in front of you, you're going to find more support and it'll hopefully make your life easier in the long run. Our eighth tip is to get some help. This goes hand in hand with that last tip, but if you have kids or pets or just other obligations like everyone does, line up some help, come up with some alternatives so that you're not working and kids and studying solo. You know, have extra childcare help. Make sure that your spouse or significant other is on board with them maybe needing to take on more of the responsibility. But do what you got to do. Enlist a grandma, hire a dog walker. This way, you can make sure you're dedicating your time to bar prep and that you don't have to do it again. Our ninth tip is kind of like what I already said about taking breaks, but this time I want to be more specific. Make sure you're taking care of yourself. If you're not, you're going to burn out more quickly and ultimately maybe not be successful on the bar exam, or you might not even make it to the bar exam. You might decide to give up and that it's not worth it or it's not working for you. And then all of the time you've already dedicated to studying is kind of wasted. So make sure that you're doing whatever you have to do to take care of yourself. This means you're sleeping adequately, you're eating healthy, maybe taking some time to exercise, you're taking care of your mental health and the like. Our 10th tip is to be creative when you study. Some people tell me they take their outlines to work and they study during lunch. Some people tell me they downloaded an MBE app on their phone so that way they can do questions while at work and they're not lugging a big book around. But get creative. If you have an attack outline or a one sheet, something that's easy to throw in your briefcase or in your backpack or carry around with you to look at whenever you get a free few minutes, do it. You might find that it actually works when you have some extra time to study. Our 11th tip is to think critically about whatever assignments are given to you. I don't want you to blindly follow someone else's to-do list. You're already really busy. So I want you to make sure that everything you're doing because you feel like it's going to make you better or get you closer to that goal of passing. So if you have a bar prep commercial course that's maybe having you do random memorization tests, or some questions that maybe aren't multiple choice questions or they don't resemble what a real multiple choice question looks like, maybe you don't do them. Maybe instead you just work on active review or you do an essay instead. So again, you wanna make sure that you're being picky and choosy about how you spend your time since you will be more limited with it. And then lastly, see if you can take some time off work. Now, this doesn't mean you need to take 2 months off work. You might not be able to do that, or it might not be financially feasible. But maybe you can take some half days a few weeks at a time. That'll alleviate some stress. Maybe you can take a day off every other week. Maybe you can take the last 2 weeks of our prep off. Get creative and see what your employer will offer, because a little can go a long way. Hopefully these tips help you study while working.